Shepherd of soul, Shepherd of a soul,
Savior of a soul, Lover of a soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcomers, for the Lord God is on our side. We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We
Yes, Lord.
My ears are open to hear. And my tongue pungent, O God, to speak about you.
Amen. Amen.
And let every ear be watched to hear from you.
Amen.
Let every heart be purified to conceal it and to use it to your glory. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Revelation chapter number 20, verse 11 to 15. Revelation 20, 11 to 15. And I read, and I saw a great white throne, and he that sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away. Is such person somebody you can do it? Okay. Whose earth, everything on earth together, and the heavens fled away from. Such a mighty man to be feared. And there was found no place for them. Wow. Verse 12. And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God. Just as Mr. Daniel knelt down before him for more than 8 hours. And the book were opened. And another book was opened, which is the book of life. Which is the book of life. Books were opened. And another one was opened, which is the book of life. Say, Father, may I be found in the book of life on that day in the name of Jesus Christ.
Father, may I be found in that book on that day in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
And the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books according to their works. According to their works. Verse 13, and the sea gave up the dead, those who had both Cathay, those who were on their way from Libya to Europe, those even in fish ate them. The Bible said the sea gave them up because they could not hold them down anymore. The Most High would come and face the judgment, the reason why they were coming to Europe illegally. Or what were they looking for in that sea? I pray when we shall come before him on that day, we shall have a right life, a pure garment, and a perfect fire to to present before him in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But see, and death are hell. Please take note of this. The death we are afraid of now, that Apostle Paul said, so that person not kill me, let not preach about Jesus. If I preach about him now, they will kill me. I don't want to die. The Bible says, the death we are running from now, and hell, we are what? Cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. The death your grandfather, your grandmother died that first time, that they died in sin, or found their son in hell, that one is just the first death. The real death is coming. The real one is coming. Verse 15. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life, sir, whosoever president, senator, pastor, apostle, children, whosoever that was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. It means, if you are alive, when that day will come? Before death, if you are alive, when that day will come, and you are found guilty, before death, we experience with distress in the lake of fire. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
So, what is the message before us this hour? The message for us is this. How prepared are you for hell? Somebody might say, to be I'm not prepared for hell. This is the message he said, I should give you unto myself. How prepared are you for hell? But I want to quickly tell you this. No matter how prepared you may be, you can never be well prepared enough for that place. Is somebody hearing me?
Amen. I think so. Amen.
No matter how ready you are to live there, no matter how prepared you may think you are prepared, a second in hell will take away all the preparation you are not prepared. You can never be well prepared enough to be able to bear what you see there. You can never be brave enough. You can never, let me be bathing every second so that when I get there, since I know I'm not going to bath the eternity, I am bathing every second now. Let me bath for reserve. Let me be eating, so that when I get there, all the food I'll be eating, let me eat them for reserve there. There's nothing you will use that you will prepare enough. There's nothing you will gather here that will be enough to make you live in that place. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
I just want to make some people here to know what you should be prepared yourself for. Since they are preaching to you, you don't want to listen. Since they are telling you to repent, you are saying no. Since the ministers, whoever the Lord is using to talk to you, is saying it every day, you are thinking it's a joke. Or you are saying, don't mind them. I just want to let you know today what you should be preparing your mind for, because you will surely get it if you don't repent. You are going to be seeing a place where there is a compulsion. community, all your prayer here, all your pomposity here, all your egocentric here, in that place you are preparing for, you will be humbled, compulsively humbled. Your humility will come just like that. All your pride will be swallowed up even before you enter the place you want to send yourself to. All the reason why you are saying don't mind them, all the reason why you are saying I have to do this first before I listen to them, under a second, or under a second, you will forget them. A place of compulsory humility. Isaiah chapter 5, 14 to 15. Therefore, hell hath enlarged herself, waiting for you. You that say, Apostle Mammon is wasting time. You that say, the minister said they are jobless, that's why they are doing what they are doing. You that say, let me keep on sinning. Until God Himself talk to me in the dream, no problem. Hell has enlarged itself waiting for you if you repent. And open a mouth wide without measure. Hell has opened his mouth wide without measure. And their glory, all the glory you are carrying now, no supposed to say, I am too beautiful to enter hell. Can't you see that king? The Lord will not allow you to see your king. Hallelujah. I am too handsome to enter there. Look at everything I acquired. How can God allow such person to go there? Is God so wicked? No. If you're wicked, then they send you there. The Bible says their glory and their multitude and their pomp and he that rejoices shall descend into it. You are rejoicing over a liberty now. Don't worry. You are a prostitute rejoicing over your prostitution. You are building houses with your prostitution. You are a drug pusher. You are rejoicing over a drug dealing. No problem. Enjoy as long as your breath remains. You are moving from one woman to the other as a husband to somebody. No problem. Enjoy it so long your breath remains. All you are doing is how to bring people down. No problem. Keep on doing it. But I tell you this, you will fall and fall and fall, go down and down and down. You will not get to the bottom of it. You will never get to where you get to. Hell will come for you up. Fire will come up. And you will become fire. Praise Master Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sister, brother, all ye sinner, all repentant sinner, if you don't repent, you will descend into hell. Verse 15. And the man, and the new man, shall be brought down. You are so wicked. You are so stubborn. Nobody can talk to you. Not even your wife will talk to you, you will hear. You are looked down the world, nobody can talk to you. You are so proud of yourself in your evil. You will descend down into hell, and you will be humbled. Shall be brought down. And the mighty man shall be humbled. Brother, you will be humbled. And your humility will remain, you will remain humbled for eternity. Sister, you will be humbled. Nobody can talk to you now in that church. You are the, whatever they call you there, no problem. The lion or the tribe of your family you are. If your father cannot talk to you, your mother cannot talk to you, when your husband talks, you stop it. Don't problem, keep up. But I tell you, the place of compulsory humility is waiting for you. You'll be humble. and the eyes of the lofty shall not be troubled. Your eye is like a gate, it's always looking up. Sister, bring your eyes down now. This time that you have to see how the grace will bring your eyes down. Bring it down. You want to buy the latest car. You want to do the best house. Bring your eyes down now and live your life according as the Lord asks you to live it. So your goals are calling to the size of the cross you can afford them. Don't live your life for people to praise you. Don't do things for people to say, yes, that my brother in Europe is very rich. Don't do it. Bring your eyes down. All those eyelids, remove them. Remove them. All those things in your eyes that make your eyes to become, bring them down. Because a place is coming where you shall be brought down. 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 Yeah, and nobody will care about you anymore. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
You are great. Those of them, you have helped Caesar gift. That's what I pray. Father, say that brimstone of fire. The one you say, Caesar here, is a little one. The one you experience where you have pushed yourself to, the brimstone of fire, you will see every second. The one she shouted down, you cannot see this candy. You will see lightning and fire and brimstone will be raining on you. In hell, that place you are going to, please prepare yourself to see the brimstone and fire that Sister X Y is shouting every day, raw. Ways. So please prepare yourself to receive brimstone and fire. Hell is a place of constant brimstone and fire dropping down. The more the anger of God is raging, the more brimstone and fire. You don't have to pray there. It's already a place for it. You don't pray for evil to come here. It's already a place of epic evil. It's already a place of brimstone and fire. So please, my sister, my brother, the unrepentant people, please get yourself ready to express it. The Bible says in Revelation 21 and 8, Revelation 21 and 8, but the fearful and unbelieving, you that are afraid of somebody because of that fear, you don't want to do the right for God, unbelievable, and unbelieving, Apostle Manuel will be saying some things, preaching, you might be saying, it is not true. Know that you have prayed and God has told you not true. Or maybe you have said scripture in your heart because of your hatred for me. It's not Apostle Manuel that will tell you. You say, no, it can never be true. No problem. Don't believe. And the abominable and murdering in any kind. Either you use knife, you use tongue, whatever you use to murder a person, get ready for brimstone and fire. Whosoever, and woman murderers, and sorcerers, and idolaters, and all liars shall have their parts in the lake with burning with fire and what? Brimstone. Fire and what? Brimstone. Which is what is second death. You know, today when I was thinking about this people said to me, please. Thank you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, this is the first thing I just forgot. He said, when you are so proud now, when you die, death will first of all make ingest of you. After death, before you start going to where you're going to. Maybe you are very rich. Thank you, Father. Maybe you are very wealthy. Because of your car, you don't serve God. Because of a house, you don't understand God. Because of a husband, you don't understand God. Because of my wife, I will not serve God. He said, and you are married to us here. When you die, they will give you about 5 seconds or 2-3 minutes to see what you die for. When you leave your body, they will give you time. You'll be seeing your dead body on the ground. They will give you time to see your car again, to see those children again, to see that husband again. And they will show you how they are crying over you. You will try to hold them. You cannot hold them. Then you are no more in your own self again now. Say now, they will take you to where you park your car. They will do it so that you will want to enter that car. You will put your hand on the key, your hand will enter inside through. You are now a spirit. It will order a circus. Is that what you're telling me?
Yes, sir.
Good. This one chapter will happen under circus. The house you are building, you are saying, we tie this house until I finish it with iniquity. I will not stop. It will take you to that house. They will want you to enter into it. You will sit down in the chair. You will sit down, you back the chair, and now everything you died for, those things you are doing that make you to serve God, for it to pay you, for it to know the wastefulness of those things, for you to know the uselessness of those things and the foolishness of yourself, will make you to pass all those things that make you to serve God. And you will see that you cannot endure them anymore. And if they want to punish you anymore, they will make you to see that somebody who came to greet your wife or your husband that you never allowed to turn that car before, they will use that car to say, take the car key, go and buy a drink, come. To serve this for he or she that died. And what you want to leave your garage by going. You will say, stop! You can't be talking, but nobody will hear you. So after all the drama and all, you think that move. So can you see the vanity of having your rights? Can you see what you die for? They are not ready to die with you. You are living and now say bye-bye to them. Say bye-bye and go straight to where you desire. May I not die in sin in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As he was explaining to me, in the tomb, I was shaking. I was shaking. Say, God, say yes. Tell them. Tell them. Everyone that died in sin is always giving time to look around the world again to see if that thing you died for will follow you. They will not take anything on earth before God in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Brethren, I want, let me bring down my voice. Maybe with this, you might hear me very well. I want you to understand, sister and brother, you that is still dwelling in sin, you that when we are preaching, you be thinking we are joking. Hell was never meant for you, don't go there. Hell is not a place you can live in. Hell is not a place that we ever laugh again in eternity. Hell is not a place you will ever see smile again. You will never see smile again. You will never know what is called rest again. You will never know what's it called? Again. The Bible told us in Matthew 25. Matthew 25, verse 41. Then shall he say also unto them on the left hand, depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire. My beloved brothers and sisters, it is everlasting. Hell is everlasting. Everlasting place of hopelessness. Everlasting place of restlessness. Everlasting place of shame and disgrace. Everlasting place of torment. In the everlasting fire, prepare for the devil and his angels. Prepare. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Matthew 25:41. Then shall he say also unto them on the left hand, depart from me. This will not be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Into everlasting fire. Jesus Christ speaking. Christ can never joke. Prepare for the devil and his angels, sir. Hell was prepared out of great anger in the God. Hell is a place prepared when God was furious, when God was angry, and whoever that entered there had incurred the anger of God. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Sister, do you want to go to hell? Brother, do you want to go to hell? Please, if you want to go, prepare yourself for a place for eternal destruction. Destruction every day. They'll be destroying you, but you'll never be destroyed. You'll only be feeling the pain. The unbearable. I can't bear it anymore. What will be getting is? You'll be going through it. Jesus, come and help me. I can't stay here anymore. But there's no road to come out. There's only road to hell. No road out of it. There's only a door into hell. Sister, brother, no door out of it. Matthew 10:9-8. And fear not them which kill their body. Sister Abel, listen to this. Fear not them that kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul. But rather, fear him without. Good. Fear him, God Almighty, Jesus, which is able to destroy both your soul and the body in hell. Your soul will face destruction. And your body will face destruction. A place of eternal destruction. 2 Thessalonians says, verse 10. See, it is a righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you. Verse 7. And to you who are troubled, rest with us. Rest with us. When the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels, is in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God, and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord shall take vengeance upon everyone that refuse to hear the gospel of God. Now you are matching the tongue of the Holy Spirit of God. You are thinking you are doing it. No, no, no. Whenever I speak his word, I'm using the tongue of the Holy Spirit. And whenever I say no, it's a lie. I don't believe. You are just matching the tongue of the Holy Spirit on the ground. 9. Who shall be punished with everlasting destruction? For the the Lord, and for the glory of his power. Verse 10. When he shall come to be glorified in his sake, and to be admired in all them that believe, because our testimony among you was believed in that day. Let God go where we stay now, no problem. Let God and join together as a two of Christ, no problem. But a day is coming when all your eyes shall be open. Then they will know what they've done with us. Sister, you can say whatever you need to say now, so long you have breath in you. Sister, you brother, you can do whatever you choose to do to yourself, so long you have breath. But a day is coming, you will realize what you have done to yourself. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
You that is running from one prophet to the other now, go and buy all shoes. You that you are only here because of what your selfish body is looking for, get yourself ready. When they are preaching, you close your ears. But when deliverance comes, you open. When they are preaching, your ears are closed. When you come to deliver healing, you will open that ear. No problem. Get yourself ready. When Apostle Emmanuel is preaching, he's your friend. He's your enemy. But when the Lord is using him to do deliverance and healing, he became your friend. After 3 days, nothing of such is nothing is done. They have become your enemy again. Keep on going up and down like a butterfly. You will meet yourself where you deserve someday. But I am here to answer you. The only reason why you should be here is because of the word of God. Every other reason I want to share country. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
If you are not loving me because of the truth, because of the word of God, don't love me. If you are loving me because of all the things that are in your to your soul, you are loving me for the detriment of your own soul. You must love me because of the word of God, because of holiness and righteousness. If you must talk about this ministry, talk about it for the people, for the world you are hearing. Every other thing is an addition, and those additions cannot take you to heaven. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
The Bible tells us in Revelation chapter number 19, verse 20, and the beast was taken. And he, the first prophet, that wrought miracle before him. They are everywhere now. After this preach, now, this is not what I expected this morning. You carry for one day, you and this first prophet, you see yourself in hell. Don't do everything humanly, spiritually possible to make up. All you are doing is to gather momentum. The money you are gathering is to start calling prophet over there. The strength you have is how to sit down and carry a phone book from one pastor to the other, one prophet to the other. Keep up! Your name is in the book of destruction. You better make up your mind now to cancel it there. From there, else you will forever regret why your father ever met your mother. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Those who serve the image, the beast himself, you that is serving them, you that pastor came out as an angel of light, petting you, preaching love to you. And you are saying those who are telling you to repent, they are pretty hatred. And those who are saying love, iniquity, those who prayers and the prophets that follow, follow them. But on that day, both you and them and the devil that called them, they enter the lake of fire that will never stop burning. After preaching, they say, these people are so, let me go to where the light, maybe you have problem. No, go there. In hell, you will never see such light. I was thinking after preaching, after serving, the pastor sharing light, sharing more for me. This is no more to drink. I will not come again. No problem, don't come again. Go to where they are drinking more. Go to where they are even drinking beer. Some church man, they drink beer. There's a place where they even smoke. If you need church where they smoke in your hand, smoke for you, now you can find it. Church where they drink alcohol, you can find it. Church where they, when you get there, the pastor will give you a gift to go and sleep with people, you come back and listen. You can find it now, or else. Whatever you wish to get now to enjoy your flesh, you will receive evil rights in the church. Run away and enter them. So I tell you, when the consequence comes, you and your soul alone will get it. Pray that like Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
That's what the people are. I give one more thing that we have here. We hear. You are preparing yourself for the place where the worm will be eating you. You never die, and the fire that will burn your intestine will never quench. Your intestine will turn to fire. This head, you are saying, I have to maintain the head for my husband. Maintain it for your husband. Go and buy the attachment that will reach leg. Maybe that's like when you don't know where to go live. Go and buy it and enjoy yourself. So long as you have breath in your nostril, one that never die is waiting for you. Fire that can never be quenched. Sometimes I'll say, God, I wish you can show people her fire. Sometimes when we are preaching it, it's as if it's a fallacy. Sir, I wish you may do it, you may be like that. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And we always do what we do. That's why it's called Jehovah.
Yes.
Brother, sister, please don't go to hell. I am begging myself. I am begging you. I am begging my brethren here. I am begging everyone that cares to listen to me. Don't go there. You get to read Mark 9:43. 48. He said, whatever that will push to hell, avoid it. If your hand we make to sin to go to hell, cut the hand off. Sister, that friend that is driving to hell, cut yourself from that friend now. That character, cut yourself from it. Because if that is succeed, he sent me to that of hell. Oh God, you will regret. You will cry, but God will be there for you. You cry and cry and cry and cry. Your tongue, then you will know that this tongue. Some people say this tongue is very long. Very long. Tongue is longer than tongue. You're coming out, coming out, coming out, and coming out. This eyeball, you will know that there is something, God is powerful. There is something, you will hold it there. Like a vein. If you drop out, make it a you will see it clearly. The demon will cut off the head, throw it away. God, I am not not joking on. Cut out the hand in particles. So the demons, they are programmed to do evil. They can, if you say, I beg, I please, that is doing the more. When you say, please, I never knew. For you to say, I never knew. More problem for you. Hey, I hear, I did not. For you to say, hey, okay, you heard? More problem. Any excuse there give you more punishment. The hand that threw away, you'll be seeing your own hand dancing and coming. More intestine coming. That's where all these are children, they should stop watching all this cartoon. That's where they got them from. It's like cats never die. You don't do it. The mother is casting, that's how whoever that enter here is. How they come. Each child will be crying and will cry. They will use cutters to open the skull and remove the brain. This brain will allow us to help you use. This brain does not receive the true gospel. You are using it to receive nonsense. They remove it and put it in your hand. They'll tell you, change the fire. You will throw the brain into fire. You make it. The hell will open. Later, the brain will lay the fire again and enter. That is the pain. It's too painful. No matter how I describe it, it's the minimal time more than this. Nobody can describe hell the way it is. It's indescribable. I want you to stand up and say, Father, if I was preparing myself for her, unknowingly, I prepare for it no more. If I was preparing myself for her unknown to me, I've decided not to prepare myself for it no more. Hell, you will not see me again. Jesus, give me the faith to live my life worthy of heaven. I repent of all my sin, sickness, sin, open sin. I see no more. Help me, Lord Jesus. God, I pray.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Amen. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we say that pray.
Amen.
Get home. Please prepare for yourself. Those who will be driving at this moment will be driving. I shall bear you up in praying. After now, I will find a few going to pray in the past. Shall we go? God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. You are not born again. You are on your way to hell. After hell, the lake of fire. Hell is the junction between earth and lake of fire. Hear me?
Yes, sir.
Hell is the junction between earth here and lake of fire. See here, next for it to be for that you enter there. Say after me, say, Lord Jesus, I've heard the word. We have stood apart in this God here. I am sorry for living the life worthy of such a grace before them. I repent of all my sins. Wash me with your blood. Take my name away from the book of death. Now please let me be written in the book of life. I accept the Lord Jesus Christ as my Lord and personal Savior. Come into my life. Come and be the God of my life. I am born again today. All things have passed away, and all things have become new. I go now to sin no more, and to live a life worthy of heaven. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray with you if you have confessed confession. My Father, my God, I thank you, I bless you, I worship you. I thank you for the privilege you've given us, O God, to hear your word again. Jesus, some of all that know me before, Father, we have been confessed again. Those who are not held at all, they have been told about it. Father, every one of us who are on this mountain and nobody will say, I am not here. Father, these ones who are joining us and we that are already on the race, Father, take away the spirit of carelessness from us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, give us the grace to be conscious of ourselves. Give us the grace, the power to run from those things that will push us into where you are going to describe to us now.
Amen.
Father, on the last day, let no one that hear this message find themselves in that place, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, the devil will not ask me, did you preach it? The devil will not ask your children, did you hear it? But rather, the Lord God Almighty, use this message to push us into your kingdom in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, those of us right now thinking it's a joke, thinking the man I've come to crack joke again, I've come to say it again. Father, please have mercy upon them and let that demon speaking to the heart be chased away from them in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Because I know your mercy is there for us on that day.
Amen.
In Jesus Christ's mighty name, I pray.
Amen.
Those who are getting set for heaven shall live in hallelujah.
Amen.